Welcome back to Eat the Race. This is week 200, day 7, the final day. And if you look at over here, we have 27 minutes, so we're just start with our battle first. In case something like yesterday happens. Oh, by the way, yesterday's video, it did cut off on that battle, and that was the last battle that we fought with Indos and units. And yeah, I wasn't sure when it was cut off. I was taking a look at the clock, making sure to keep an eye on it, but it just so happened that when I stopped looking, that's when it happened. Lots of healers. I'm assuming odd tempest on you. All recovery is what I meant to say. All recovery on you, and you have damage reduction and debuffs, openings, and ground scatcher. Not damage reduction, cooldown reduction is what I meant to say. Yeah. So, Micaiah might actually hit kind of hard. She is the scariest thing. But this is just basically Fjorm again. It really is. Things like this, people just want you to use Fjorm. Like, they're using Flash. What do you want? Fjorm is literally the only far safe tank that looks at someone with Flash and then says, like, whatever, I don't care. Alright, so we'll just put her here. Put her here. In order to break that. Alright, break that. That is an interesting question. I guess this is how we break it from here. Once we block this, it really means that it's... Then I guess I don't have to do anything special, just move you, move you, move you, and that's it. We don't need pods, so... Yeah, I mean, like, if you're gonna use... You kind of force people to do certain things, depending on what you're doing for your strat, so... yeah, we'll prevent the 10 damage from Duma, since that's literally the only thing we can do.
If you want, speak.
Yes. It is day 7. This map is definitely not designed to go against day 7.
I seek a foe.
I won't lose.
Oh yeah, odd recovery. Odd recovery.
Summer at last.
Alright. Micaiah just does like 25 damage.
Princess,
and she has a brave effect. I do not remember Brave Micaiah. I'm gonna be honest. I don't see her ever that I didn't remember that she had a brave effect. Kubis on the body of Venus Rest minus force rest. Unit makes a guarantee for pull up. Initiates combat unit will attack twice. Wait, 15? I don't know. Somehow I don't think my Fjorm had under 51 rest.
I can do that.
I might be wrong, but in order for there to be a 15 effect, well, I guess she does get, what, more from this, that's plus 6. And I guess she did have that plus 16 over here, so 17. So Fjorm will have to have 54 rest, I guess. I guess I'll give it to them.
Sure.
Yeah, definitely, I do not remember anything about Micaiah. I don't remember seeing her ever in an Aether Race map. Alright, that gives me 2 ladders. That one we could have kept going. Oh, you. I really don't like this unit. You also have teleporting abilities, so I do have to watch out for that. The best way to engage against a map like this is to bait over here to avoid. Samfunit is used, so no jumping anybody in the front. I guess from here, here would be the effective tanking place. Wouldn't want to gamble on which trap is real one and which one is fake at this point. And from here, depending on my formation, I can have as much as... Yeah, I mean, we're gonna go with this team again.
Show me your strength.
Yes, we could just do this and then ignore. But I think, do you get your Luna ready on turn one? Let me see. Special trigger cooldown minus one, which is why Luna is a 2 cooldown. Ally bring to space if it initiates combat, bring to space if an ally grants attack by soul. Units attack equals max units cooldown value times 3 during combat. Didn't you have a way to reduce your cooldown? Yeah, units max special cooldown times 3 during combat. I don't know. I remember the whole point of you was that you get your specials instantly. But I cannot recall. Yeah, I don't recall. Alright, regardless, where we want is over here. I guess you... Yeah. You won't be able to reach there. I don't remember. I know there's a thing about her being able to get her cooldown or something like that, but I do not recall. These two spots are literally the same. Where do I want Fjorm? I guess I want Fjorm where Elamine is.
By your will.
Yeah. Over here? I'll do it. Yeah. Lady Niffle.
Alright, leave. Unfortunately, because I cannot double him, he gets to live. And now he gets to die. Corrin, we do get hit with a 21. Well, 15, but yeah, see, she got her special, but I don't remember how her thing works. Like, all right, we do have her special, so, and she has a player face special, so she's... I guess I could just kill her. That would be the smart idea, so let's just kill her. Deals with her right now. Don't have to worry about it anymore.
If you want.
As for the two of you.
Sure. I'll protect you.
Wings, wings. Yeah, I'm just gonna let them come to me because both of them will move forward. I guess there's a chance of Katria moving here and getting Dance. 1, 2. That's the only unit that can do something unexpected and get Dance. Otherwise, everyone should be coming straight down. Although I don't see why Katria will go this way, since her target should be Elamine. She could also go 1, 2 and get Dance.
Yes.
So we're gonna put her in a direct path to Elamine.
I will go. Close your eyes.
Yeah. For someone to reach over here, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces from Zeros, I don't know, like, it really is not possible. Zeros can move here, get that, reposition and Dance. But I don't, there's literally like no way for anyone to reach Plumeria. Yeah, that's what I thought.
All right.
We can take out Katria. And we can take out Thor.
Yeah.
Not Thor. Zeros with Thor. All right, get rid of Katria. Mira cannot break this block, so if this block is broken, it's by Regan. So, yeah, need to put you over here then.
I can do that.
I guess Mer can just kill you. I said, like, I was gonna tank with Thor, but Mer can just kill you.
If you want.
Plus 29 defense, so 8, that means however much he's doing with bonfire chest is at least 45 damage. Or exactly 45 damage. So 45 minus 8 is 40 minus 3 is 37 times 2 is 14, 60, 74 defense. That means we had 74 defense at that moment.
Speak, Lady Niffle.
Yeah, kind of.
We're
gonna try to get the ether. No reason
close
not to.
Your eyes. Yes.
Run orders. Okay. Interesting. Yep, that's what we did back away.
I seek a foe.
Sure. Close your eyes. I can do that.
I can do this. Get this ether.
I won't lose. Speak.
Push you. Then just move one up, I guess.
By your will.
Yeah, Mira doesn't kill you, they but we do kill her. And we would have to kill Nikaya.
I seek a foe. Great Mjolnir.
Speed, 40 speed. 57 attack with an impact for the extra 8.
Over here?
Yeah, I guess we'll just kill you. No need to risk losing a unit right now. Because I don't think Elamine can take the hit. Yeah, she gets nothing from there, so it's just 57 plus 3 is 60, 63. And I know Flame gives herself damage reduction, but I don't think Element gives herself damage reduction. Yeah, it's only two allies. So yeah, 60 attack, 36, 66 is 12, 42, 52. So yeah, she would die. So,
yeah.
No need to risk losing a unit right now. When the game is pretty much over. And that is it. End of the week. 21-140. Tier 39. Should be top 3k easily. Yeah, 1692. Alright, we'll take a look at those two defense replays and be done for the week. So this is an interesting team. First off, we have Kanigas, plus 1, plus 19. Summoner supported, Lion King's Refine, Distant Defense 4, Special Fighter, Farsave, Deathrest Form. Raisin, both because they need something to be able to transform Kanigas and they need a Dancer. Walmart, plus 10, plus 20. So this is another unit you run into very often. His bonus unit this week, which I guess we chances were to run into him at least once. Wolfberry Refine, which has that flash effect and has the attack defense menace built in. Reposition Gale Force, attack speed solo, near trace, attack smoke 4 and attack speed solo. So he does hit a pretty good speed value thanks to bonus stats. Ashera, smite defense tactics. Regan, plus 3, plus 3. Dry defense, reposition, and a plus 1 Altina with drive, double drive res. So yeah, frontline Walmart, Farsave with Kanigas, because they're running Gale Force, he doesn't actually kill Tana in one hit, and she does get to bonfire him. Goes Kuntra, only getting plus 9 attack.
This old clock still boils.
in against debuffs or something like that. I forgot. Oh, yeah, yeah. He does right now because distant defense. Neutralizes bonuses. And I'm pretty sure he neutralizes penalties. I guess not, but he was only getting hit by the attack defense res. So there's that flash effect. Take out Tannen player phase and then retreat. Yeah, he has to be neutralizing his some debuffs. Take out Trazier. Ball tower only hits Mira. And hit and retreat. It's pretty much their game plan right now. Not able to kill Seiros. Not, his res is not that good, so. And because the hex trap is right there, they're not gambling on it. Unfortunately, if you've been paying attention, he did not get attack smoke out this turn, which means he did not prevent himself from getting double. So Seiros just uses Hyper Beam. And from here on the left side, they really don't have anyone that can just take on Tiki in player phase. And then they have to deal with Murr. For this one, it's a little more simpler. We have Larum, slaying Gale Force, double speed. No cooldown accelerant though, but that's because they do have Thor. Plus one with the Brazen attack speed desperation set. Gale Force, Advent Sacrifice. The one that makes it all happen. Winter Burnie, Smite, double life from death to soak chills. That defense sling and attack tactics. Plumeria, both as a dancer as a bonus unit. Regen, plus one, Blaze Session, Wings of Mercy, and Gale Force. And Kid Azura. I don't know why specifically Kid Azura. Maybe they're just a fan of Kid Azura. Miracle, Wings of Mercy, Drive Speed, Drive Opening. Because she's like the only one that can act Gale Force in this team. So yeah, just do the Winter Burnie thing. Get yourself in desperation. They do need the speed to be able to go over like Weary Fighter effects. Now Tiki doesn't have one, so. But unfortunately, Thor just one-shots it. Because again. All those bracings plus the armor effectiveness. Gamble on a trap, fail, and that's pretty much it. These two units are dead in the water. I guess Larum doesn't have. Wait, she's not even. No, she is below half health, so why can't Larum teleport? Because Murr. Basically, this is what this team was all about, to prevent Gale Force jumping. That's why I put Murr in this team. This is why they had to try to get Thor out of there. This is the whole point of this team, to prevent Gale Force jumpings, which, hey, on the last match, it did work. It did fulfill its purpose. So yeah, that is that for this week. We do have our banner that started today, which is Hero Remix. We have Sothis, which we already plus 10, so they already changed Nosy Disrupt over here over her Wrath, which, come on. This is, out of every Legendary Hero Remix, this is probably the worst that they've done. Like, Null City Disrupt, I guess, yeah, whatever. No one can prevent her from getting Sirius out on the first turn, but that's it. That's all she can do. Get Sirius out on turn one if she doesn't get one shot, which I guess she does have a little bit of damage reduction, but it is so little. Santa Marita is the only one that I don't have in this banner, I believe. I guess I don't have Ascender Ishtar either. So the two Ascended units are the ones I don't have. But Sothis is already plus 10. Grima is already plus 10. So going colorless and going red would be a bad idea. Lynn is plus 6 or 7, I want to say. Julia, I think she's only plus 1. Duma is plus 7. Hector is plus 3, but I have like at least one or two landing around. So we can check like this. Credit by levels and only legendary heroes. Now we, Lynn is plus 6. And we don't have any extra Lynns lying around. Hector is, where is Hector? There you are. Plus 3, and I know I have at least one Hector lying around. Oh, there we go. We have two Hectors lying around, so technically he's plus 5. That's for legendary heroes, of course. Grima already plus 10. On the mythic side of things, Sothis obviously plus 10. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4 extra Sothis, which Tampos is literally the only thing I can use her for. Duma again, plus 7. And yeah, I think that was the only two mythics. Two mythics, three legendaries, 5, two ascendants, 7. Oh, Julia. Julia is the last one, with the one we didn't check. Julia is, where are you, Julia? Plus 3. And I don't know if I had, no, I don't think I have any lying around. I know I did sacrifice a Julia once for Mirror Impact, I want to say. If I did, why didn't I pass? What did it? Did I only pass Mirror Impact when I pass her? Because I'm pretty sure I fed her. Oh, yeah. The Oath. Oath skill. That's what it is. That's what I think. Because I know I gave Sothis Mirror Impact. And I think I got it. I gave it from Julia. Because, yeah, she has Mirror Impact. But doesn't look like I gave it from her, because there's nothing else that... I know we have Warding Blow or Mirror... What is it? Mirror Strike on something else, so I know she has Mirror Impact. I think I got it from Julia, but I might be wrong. I don't know who else has Mirror Impact in this game. That's name of character. Skill search is on this one. Yeah, so this is every unit with an impact skill. Oh no, Yuni. I gave her to Yuni. That's who it is. So Yuni should have. Yeah, Yuni has attack res of 2 for some reason. She didn't get of 3 for some reason. But yeah, it was Yuni who I gave, who I fed a Julia to. I was like, I know I have somebody, I use one Julia for that. Everybody else was a 4 muscle, and the other ones, they come with an impact skill. So I don't remember who I gave impact skill to Sotis from then. Probably Tivern? No, she has mirror impact. Not Kid Soren, because Kid Soren. So I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember. Oh, Seiros! Seiros was the one that gave it because you, Sotis has Dragon Ball. There we go, mystery solved. I did get my... Yeah, I did collect this before I forget. Season ended. Can we still see where you guys ended up? Yep, we got Matt in first place, Michael, Dark Luster, Neo Swordsman, Promise, Kenny, Diego, Brave Blitz, CMA, Gabs, Lembras, Quips, Kitsune, Logan, Eva, Oron, Dogs, Patch, Yakiomi, Kako, and that's pretty much it. So, look like a lot of you did pretty well this week. Yeah, just pretty much base kit. That's all she needs. Like, that refine was really, really good for Julia. And Claude. Claude benefited a lot from this, although this does make me sad to see that Promise Feather Claude a Byleth. Next week is light season. Well, it is already light season, but with Uller on offense and Meteos on defense. Do we have a team with Meteos already set up? We got this team, which is a full score team because it is fire season. So for now, let's just make this the default team. And the only thing we will have to change is that we know it is armor school. I'm pretty sure it's armor school. Yeah, no, flying school. Flying school, place. Flying school. Yeah, for now we'll just leave this team. We do have Lisa at +9 now though. So yeah, +9 Lisa now. We did get that one from the Ephemera. So now we just wait for her to come in as a format to pick up her final copy and then give her a lot more premium stuff. And that's when we'll finally give her like Farsave. Farsave, I don't know. Offensive stats, there really isn't that many. But for now, we'll unlock it when we're ready to see, make sure that everything is set up properly. But that is it for this season. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.